We're coming to you from inside Compass Circle. And in this video, you're gonna get a construction update. And we're asking the question, when will this building be open so we can gather together in here as the church? This space right here, Compass Circle, it's an answer to prayer. It's a reminder that the good hand of God is upon our church. In 2019, the pastors were praying and we didn't know what to do. Should we stay in our building here on Argosy Avenue in Huntington Beach, or should we go to a bigger building here in the neighborhood? And God gave us an answer to prayer better than anything we were asking Him when He provided this space right across the parking lot. And this space allows us to have a meeting room for our high school ministry, a meeting room for our junior high ministry, a meeting room for our Bible classes that we want to have, a coffee shop area, more fellowship group rooms, more offices. Like, this was everything we needed and more. I don't even know if everybody knows out there that we also got this warehouse area on the end of the space where we can park the trolleys for more storage. I mean, God abundantly blessed us. But the construction project was gonna require some ambitious faith. I know for me, this was beyond anything we'd done before. And in July of 2019, we presented it to the church. We opened up an opportunity for people to give to Compass Circle, and people have given more than we ever saw before. We have everything we need for the construction to be completed. And so we've got a big meeting today. On the day we're dropping this video, we're doing a walkthrough with the owner, with the architect, and we're trying to answer the question, when will the construction be done? Because we want the building to be open. And we really need this space right now. We need a place for our high schoolers to meet during our services. We need a place for the junior hires to gather together during our services. We want to bring the Bible class back and they need a place to assemble. We want to give Trolley Coffee a home here in the coffee shop. So will you pray today that the construction will be completed soon as possible and we can use this space to assemble together as the church? I mean, we're moving into the final stages of preparation. We got our audio visual equipment that we're working on getting in here. We've got the furniture that we're starting to get for all of the different rooms. I mean, we're looking past the construction to completion and when can we start using it? And I remember how this all began. And it began with the architect, Steve Camp, and he came up with this set of plans. And it was like the thickest set of plans I've personally ever been a part of on a construction project. I mean, we've done things where we had to get approval from the city at Marina High School, or even here, how our conditional use permit when we started Saturday night services. But this level of construction, I mean, this has blown my mind. You gotta take a look at these plans. The in-depth detail of what's happening in every little spot, in every single room. And our general contractor, Mark, I mean, he knows these plans back and forward. Like, if every Christian knew their Bible like Mark knows these plans, we'd be seeing revival for sure. And Mark gets into these plans because he's actually got to build every little detail that's drawn up in there.
I gotta look at these plans every single day.
That set of plans is a perfect introduction to today's chapter, Ezekiel 40. Because in this chapter, we get another vision of Ezekiel, just like we started the book in chapter 1, where he had a vision of the glory of God, or just like in chapter 8, when he all of a sudden went from Babylon to the temple in Jerusalem. Well, here in Ezekiel 40, we have another vision where he goes up to a high mountain and he sees a temple that looks like a city. And these plans for this structure, go all the way from chapter 40 to chapter 48 at the end of the book of Ezekiel. And so you need to open your Bible and turn with me, because what is set up here in Ezekiel 40 is gonna set the tone for the rest of our study of this book here on Scripture of the Day. And so start with me right at the beginning. You'll notice we get another date. Ezekiel's given us a lot of dates, and this is one of the latest ones. 14 years after the city of Jerusalem was destroyed, that's 573 BC. The only thing later in the book of Ezekiel was what was going to happen to Egypt back in Ezekiel 29:17. So this is one of the latest prophecies we've got. We're coming to the end of the book, and I've just got to tell you, the commentaries have a lot of different things to say about what these chapters mean. Ezekiel 40 to 48. There is a lot of debate. Like, is this about how they're supposed to rebuild the temple when they come back from exile back to Jerusalem? Guys like Ezra, Nehemiah, bringing the people back. Is this how they're supposed to build the temple? Because if it is, they never do it. So a lot of people think, well, that's not it. Oh, so is this a temple that's going to fit in the new city in Revelation? Well, it doesn't sound like that. And in fact, this temple has sacrifices in it. And that's one argument that a lot of people use to say, well, this can't be about some future millennial kingdom of Israel where their Jesus is going to reign for 1,000 years, because why would they do sacrifices in that temple if Jesus is our sacrifice? And he is. He died on the cross for our sin. He rose again to give us eternal life. If Jesus has saved us and it's all by faith in what Jesus has done, then why would there be future sacrifices? And so let the debate begin. People have a lot of strong opinions about what these chapters are all about. But all of the commentaries, they have, like, here's a good picture from one of the commentaries where they kind of draw out what this structure would look like. And with the different gates and the different entrances there, you can kind of see a picture. People are like, wow, this is really detailed. We can even reconstruct it. We can draw it. What is this for? Well, one of the things that we're going to want to notice as we go through Ezekiel is that there's no instruction to actually build this. Like, that was a big observation I've had so far. Like, we're going to have to go through this together over the next few days, over the next few videos. And we'll give you an update about how construction's going in here. And we're going to have to figure out, what is this description all about here in Ezekiel? Because it's something that's described, but they're not told to build it. So what really is the point? Clearly, we can see that the place that God is going to dwell, there's a level of, like, you can't just walk into this place. You can't just enter into this place. Like, this should take us back to the tabernacle, to the temple, when God's glory was among the people. That's really what this is leading towards. There's going to be a time where God dwells with his people again. God's glory is going to be revealed to his people. And here's the moral of the story. You can't just walk up to God's glory. Like, you've got to come and approach God in the right way. You've got to know who he is. It's got to be about him and not you. You can't approach God in sin. You have to be justified. You have to be righteous to enter into the presence of a holy God. So let's not get so focused on the plans that we miss the big picture, that God is going to have his glory right there with his people. And that's definitely what we want to happen here in Compass Circle, is we want God to be among us. We want to experience a revival that comes from the Bible, where God is working in our hearts to stir us up in our souls. So let's pray for that right now, because I'm asking everybody to pray for the construction at Compass Circle to be done. So let's pray about it right now. Father, as we read from Ezekiel 40 to the end of the book, God, please show us your glory. We know that's the vision you gave Ezekiel in chapter 1. We know that's what this vision is about here at the end of the book. Let us not overlook the details, but let us not get so caught up in them that we miss you returning in all of your glory to be among your people. And God, we come before you today, everybody watching this video, and we ask that you will help Mark and everybody who's working here to do the construction, Help us get the audiovisual equipment in here, the furniture in here. And God, we want to use this space so the church can assemble, so the name of Jesus can be lifted high, so we can see your glory together. So Father, we ask that you would do that and that you would do it now. And we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.